For the turnout and how you showed up and showed your love. So this time we're starting a new series entitled
Living in a Glass House.
Wait, Living is that in it? Grass houses throwing stones. That's what we're gonna be talking about for a few. Living in glass houses throwing stones. So make sure you like. You hit that subscribe button. You press that bell so you'll be notified whenever we come on. And then share the love, baby. Share the love. So today we're going to talk about you, about a situation that's going on.
You heard him.
And he said it himself. He lied like a rock. We are talking about who?
Your boy, Empire's co-star behind Taraji, Jussie Smollett. But do you...
As he quote, the gay Tupac.
Lying like your daddy. All right, let's jump right into this.
I'll jump to that.
The most amazing part about it, and I'm not here to bash anybody, but as the story begins to unravel, before the story unraveled when we first heard about the situation, I... immediately, and he's my witness, didn't believe any of it. I believed none of it. There's no way you leave. First off, you're living in Chicago. Who leaves their house at 2 a.m. in the morning to go to...
Wait, D-B-T-B, hold on. There are three sides to every story.
Okay.
His, theirs,
and the truth. And when you say so, there, do you mean the two homeless men that wrapped the string around his neck?
I drink to that one.
I'm just saying, two homeless men beat you up. Let's go back to the beginning before I get a...
First of all, this is the first question I have for you. Why are you leaving the confinement of your house at 2 in the morning to go get a sandwich?
Excuse me.
Now...
He's Jussie Smollett.
I can understand. Hold that thought. I can understand if you was at work and you was working all night and, you know, you was at the office and you were hungry so you went to go get something to eat. I can understand that. But you're who?
Jussie Smollett.
So if you're this great star of Empire...
Did you put that in quotation?
Why? Yes. Star. of Empire. Why are you leaving your house to go get a sandwich, which should already be in your house?
I just really want to put this. It's 2 a.m. in the morning. As the old folk could say, only thing open at that time is
7-Eleven and legs.
So who's leaving at 2 a.m.? Unless he was going to 7-Eleven to get a sandwich. I'm just saying, but he said he was going to Subway, so bro, I tried to help you. But who leaves their home at 2 a.m.? To get something to eat. We now have Grubhub, Seamless, Uber Eats, but you're leaving your house at 2 a.m. to get something to eat, knowing that the city of Chicago is not one city you travel, hence, alone.
Hold on. Next question. You're this great star of this great show. Where is your bodyguard?
He's Jussie Smollett. Remember he said he's the gay Tupac? He didn't need bodyguards.
But Tupac had bodyguards.
Because he was going to kill Illuminati. I'm just saying. Bruh, as your story unravels more and more, and I did not want to talk about this situation in the very beginning because this is something we discussed and I did not want to put my mouth on it. But because that the LGBT community for so many years have been fighting for rights.
Wait.
Am I going too fast?
LGBTIAQ.
Well, it's supposed to be LGBTQIAA, I think. Well, the point is, for so many years, you guys have been fighting for legal rights. You guys have been fighting for just to be accepted. And in this society, I mean, we still deal with racism, but there are more people who are leaning into loving and accepting the fact that folks are the way that they are. As Lady Gaga would say, I was born this way. And people are starting to accept it more and more. What? Did I say something that triggered something?
First off.
Well, let me finish my thought.
Okay, go ahead.
So, for you to go ahead and pull the stunt, because this is an empire, you need a stunt devil, you should have went to work. It makes, and already with some of the preconceived or some of the thoughts that people have, or the stigmas that people have upon homosexual people, this right here will look bad. It will look awful if it comes out that the report that you made was nothing but a publicity stunt so that you can sell records.
But wait, let's look at the damage control here. The damage control is, let's look at the things that is going against him right now. Your...
The fact that he's not a singer to me.
Hold on. You're black. You're male. You're gay. You have three negative
cognitions
against you. So now you were doing something you wasn't supposed to be doing, and
what's
it didn't
the Bill
turn
voice?
Out the way that it was supposed to be turned out.
What's
so
the
now
Cosby voice?
I miss him.
He's having fun in jail.
Moment of silence, man. Oh, he ain't dead. I forgot.
We are gathered here today
for the gossip. So, you have these three things against you. So now, because you was out doing something scandalous, wrong show, by the way. You should have been on Scandalous instead of Empire, because this is a scandal.
Scandal.
You see, I don't watch it. So
Scandal. You know what, Kerry Washington, we need you to come as Olivia Pope, and you need to figure out what happened, come and fix this situation, because his publicist is, whoever his damage control team is not doing a good job in getting this fixed, because it looks horrible. It looks bad against him. It looks awful.
But you know something? This is going to be on the next episode of Law and Order.
Law and Order. Which one? SVU?
SVU.
Special Victim Jr. That's my show.
Because you know, it takes from real life. So this racist, black racism, homosexual racism.
What the?
Or is it called homophobia?
It's homophobia. What is
homophobia
racism?
And sexism. All of this is going to be on the next Law and Order SUV.
SVU. Okay. All right. We're going to stop. We're going to stop playing because this is funny. I mean, we find it hilarious. I mean, at the end of the day, we have to make a joke out of it. True and all. It is a serious subject. If it happened to you, brother, then it happened to you and it needs to stop. But if you made up an accusation to pull off a stunt like this to have make it a publicity stunt, you're wrong. And then to call yourself the gay Tupac. I want to look at the alleged story. Because the truth of the matter is, you said that you left your house at 2 a.m., right?
Mm-hmm.
This is the beginning story, because this is why I didn't believe from the jump. You left at 2 a.m. in the city of Chicago. I wouldn't even leave 2 a.m. my house to go nowhere in New York City if I'm not already out in the street. At 2 a.m. I'm on my way home. So I wouldn't leave Chicago, my apartment in Chicago, at 2 a.m. to go nowhere. Now, you were walking the street and randomly two men, this is your story, attacks you. Mm-hmm. Called you a nigger. First they asked you, were you the gay man? Or told you you was the gay man from that show. Or the faggot or sissy is the words that you said in your report that they used. And then they threw a noose around your neck. And then they spit on you, maybe, I think. And then they threw bleach on you. And they beat you up.
And then you said they had on a Make America Great Again cap on.
So, two things that I can see. Are you trying to be the gay Tupac and standing up for the rights of the homosexual community?
And we saw where that ended.
Or are you pulling a publicity stunt because record sales and you want people to tune in to Empire because you want people to feel bad for you? But then you shoot a picture or a snapshot, you or Lee Daniels showed a picture of you in the hospital bed on FaceTime or one of these social media video apps, you and him on the phone.
Hold on. They threw bleach on you, number one. If anybody have bleach thrown on them, there will be spots in their clothes, no matter what did they wear. Where is the bleach clothes? That's number one. Number two, they tried to lynch you, but they put a noose around your neck, drug you down the street by the neck, carrying a noose. Where are the rope burns? Next thing that I'm concerned about is you take situations that are nothing to be played with and you use it to your advantage, all because you want to save face and save your name.
And the crazy part is you have all of these people, gay, straight, which they call the SAs, the Straight Alliance. These people are really standing with you. This is the most craziest part, is that this story has hit the black community, have hit entertainment, have hit the gay community, and these folks are literally standing up with you, believing the shenanigans. Because, again, I don't believe it. I did not believe it from the very beginning when the reports were put out, and I don't believe it now. Now, the even what makes it worse is that the police said in any of the tapes that they saw in the surrounding area, you were not attacked. So, my only conclusion to this.
But hold on. Then they asked to see evidence of your phone.
Oh,
and
yes.
You said
you can't be without your phone for 7 hours. Bro, let me explain something in what I know. If they subpoena your phone, bro, the truth is going to come out. So if this is a stunt, you and whoever stunt devil that you sat with to pull his stunt didn't think this all the way through at all. And it's horrible. It's horrible because, one, you're black. And they're gonna start looking at us that we're making false accusations just to get publicity. They already enough don't believe us now as a community of black people, and you make it worse for the gay community because they already have an issue and they feel like now you're just gonna be lying. They're not gonna take abuse, domestic violence or abuse or any of these things seriously because of a stunt you pulled. Or pulling, rather.
There was a story that we were told as kids about the girl that cried wolf. Cried wolf so much.
Nobody believed her.
That nobody believed her story.
Or even Red Robin Hood.
And when the wolf actually came, it devoured her. Because nobody believed nothing that had come out of her mouth. Now, here's the problem that we have with your situation. You didn't think it all the way through, but look who it affects. It affects black people who actually deal with racism. Yep. And you triggered a nerve because, let's be real, they just recently made lynching a crime. So now you bring this into the situation where some people really haven't gotten over it.
Yep.
And then even in some small cities and towns, that still can go on and nobody will say anything.
Yep.
So now you're toddling a fence that's just wasn't worth climbing. Next thing you do, you may get a homophobic issue.
A hate
after
crime.
All that's been going on and all the people that are of this lifestyle have been abused, you now take it and make fun of it. Not only do you do that, but now you have the nerve to even add the political drama of this red hat with the mega on it. You were going all out, my brother. So now you bring the racism of a country being divided, then a people being divided,
and then a community being divided. You just dividing it more and more, bro, and don't even realize how you're hurting. Listen, damage control, how this would work, apologize for all of the trouble that you caused before it gets any worse, because you're causing trouble and don't even realize you're causing trouble. Brother, fix it before this gets out of hand.
Because what happens now is, if you lie, now you have to tell a lie to cover up that lie.
That's what it sounds like.
Another lie to cover up that lie.
You're covering
the
lies.
And another lie to cover up that lie. And you're going to forget the first lie you told and wind up telling the truth. And then look what happens. Yeah. Now you're really hurt in the long run. Your money has been hurt. Your character has been hurt. And now you have now put your coworkers in the situation, because now your coworkers feel that there should be more security around them. My brother, what were you thinking? Better yet, were you thinking at all?
He wasn't when he was on that app.
Which head were you thinking with, bruh?
Don't let me tell the story from my theory. Cause I ain't gonna try to badger you, brother. I know what I feel in my heart, and I know what I feel in my spirit. I feel the spirit. I feel the spirit coming on. I feel the spirit.
Now, here's the thing. I can understand.
I feel the spirit coming on. Let's tell the truth.
From your point of view, I can understand that it would not look right that you were caught in this little diabolical situation, and it would have tarnished your name. It would have been publicized, but let me tell you something. It would have been publicized, but it would have brought more traffic to you, because now people want to see if this stuff is true.
Because it'll be a real hate crime. But a laundry string that people in the South in their backyard use, a clothing line. That's what they put around your neck. That's what the cops and the reports said it looked more like. I mean, all you're going to have is like rope burn, string burn. We don't even see the burn. And where's the pictures? Because if you were attacked, when you make reports, police are supposed to take pictures immediately of the attack. We have not seen those released. And the police wouldn't be able to release them. Your lawyer would be able to get them so that they can be released. But are you not taking... I take it you're not taking this to court. Because they found the two men, and then they didn't find the two men.
And but then now the two men were homeless?
Oh, not even that. That is not even the worst part about all of this. I personally believe the two men being homeless was the worst part about all of this.
No question.
The worst part was you were leaving your house at 2 a.m. to go look for a Subway sandwich.
No, but here's...
A Subway sandwich.
But wait.
A Subway sandwich.
But wait.
Like, and then it was two men that beat you up?
Wait, hold on. No.
A sandwich and two men beat you up? Let's be real about the situation here.
No. What kind of homeless men were they? Were they homeless men that were beggars? Were they homeless men that...
And then the neighborhood you live in, we could never believe that homeless people were walking around just beating people. It would have been reported numerous times that people are walking around in your neighborhood. I doubt you live in the hood of Chicago. Let's just be real about the situation, and just homeless people just randomly walked up to you. Just randomly walked up to you at 2 a.m. And there was no one else on the streets, and they beat you up.
And how did they know you was the gay one from Empire? Homeless people don't have to be.
There's watching in the homeless shelters. That's not funny. Why do I say stuff like that? And that's just not funny. Just a little bit. I'm just saying. So two homeless people
identified you.
Okay, we know in homeless shelters, they have to be in home at a certain time, at the shelter, so they can get a bed. So these two men just randomly didn't get their beds, decided to walk around in the middle of the night and found you on the street. And then beat you up because they have a problem with gay people. I doubt homeless people have it. Homeless people in their mind, their issue right now is gays. I think they're trying to find a place to live, a place to sleep, and a place to keep warm because it is the wintertime. But they're more concerned with your gays, your Jesse Smollett walking down the street. What is it? Did they rob you for some money?
Now, I couldn't believe that if you said now you was robbed and money was taken from you. But nothing was taken from you, but was given to you. Rope burn, a noose.
And bleach. And racist slurs. Homophobic slurs.
My brother, make it right before it get too out of hand.
Please do.
Because it will ruin your reputation further than you could ever imagine.
The people want the truth. The people want the truth. Just give the truth to the people. That's it. Just tell the truth. The truth was, and we're not going to hold you too much longer, but okay, let's do it this way. Something new. Do you believe the story? True or false? True or false? Do you believe the story and why?
False. I do not believe the story. I do not believe it at all. Because it just does not make sense to me. It plays my intellect. It makes me feel like I'm dumb. So I truly don't believe the story at all. There's no evidentiary support. There's nothing to back it. So maybe I'm wrong. True or false? Do you believe the story?
I don't believe none of it. I don't believe none of it. Do you know what I believe? Can I be honest? I believe you left your house at 2 a.m. literally. Or maybe 1:59. But at 2 a.m.
Don't mention whatever the name of the app is because we're not being sponsored by them. So you have no free publicity.
You were on social media apps. And whatever you were looking for did not go the way it was planned. And don't get me wrong, maybe a fight broke out. Maybe.
Oh, no, wait. Or maybe it went too good.
And maybe a fight broke out. And because your pride was hurt, your feelings were hurt, you decided that you wanted to say that it was a hate crime. Listen, let's go back into history. If this was a real hate crime, believe you me, anybody who knows history would know about Matthew Shepard. We're not going to go deep into that. And everybody who knows about Matthew Shepard know what happened. That is a hate crime. Your story sounds like a transaction went wrong. And you use it as a publicity stunt to get traffic your way. And if Lee Daniels have anything to do with this, because we know how crooked and evil he is.
Oh, that's another story, so we need not to even go there. Because
so my brother,
in glass houses,
let me tell you something.
Throwing stones.
America wants the truth. And I'm going to tell you something right now, what I've learned in life. If you tell the truth, and the people will love you and accept you more because you decided to tell the truth. But let them find out that all of this was nothing but accusations and lies. Your career is done. Empire will lose ratings. And you, my brother, will be without jobs. Okay? So whoever your team is, from me to you, get rid of them. Because if they're backing this shenanigan, then you don't need them in your life. And brother, you're not Tupac. You're not the Black Panther Party. So let's not act like you are. Because what you're doing is not something Tupac would have done. And what you're doing is not something the Black Panther Party, would have stood up for. So if you're going to be a civil rights leader, let's do it the right way and not do it this way. So people can jump a bandwagon, literally, that has holes. Your tires ain't got no air. So I don't know where you're going with this story. But my brother, make it right with the world. Make it right with the community. And if you want to unify us the right way, my brother, don't tell no lies.
So, you know what, everyone? My jam squad out there.
Oh, one more thing. And the truth of the matter about all of this, give your story the truth so that there can be three sides to the story. Because right now we have ours, what we think from the lies that you've told so far, and theories. But the moment you can give your truth, there's three sides. And we won't hate you for it. Because we all make mistakes.
We would appreciate you for the truth. So, Jam Squad, now we ask you the question.
True
or false? Which one do you believe and why? So, tune in next time. We're going to continue this series entitled Living in Glass Houses, Throwing Stones.
Brother, your life is all on the TV. Living in a glass house.